Hello, beloved ones. I am Matt Kahn, and as always, it is an absolute pleasure and privilege to serve you. Thank you for joining me for this beautiful loving kindness meditation as a gift for your healing journey that we intend to radiate outwards to bless the lives of all of your loved ones and to extend to all corners of the globe and to all sentient hearts within view and beyond. As we begin this loving kindness meditation, let us just start by finding a very comfortable place to sit. Whatever brings you safety and comfort, whether lying down or sitting up. And as we breathe, let's focus on the breath being slow and gentle instead of deep. Oftentimes when we take deep breaths, we tend to take deep, quick breaths. But for this loving kindness meditation, what if we just take a slow, gentle breath? And whether you want to inhale through your nostrils or your mouth, whatever is most natural for you, simply breathe in nice and slowly and gently. And breathe out slowly and gently. For in our first experience of loving kindness, we're just going to breathe in gently and breathe out gently, allowing the in-breath to be savored, allowing the out-breath to be savored. And already in that, you can feel yourself ground into your body, become naturally present, without making it something to check off the to-do list. Easy for me to say. So we breathe in gently. And we breathe out gently. And in this loving kindness meditation, maybe we breathe in love into all parts of self. And as we breathe out kindness for all beings. With the in-breath, breathing in love. And on the out-breath, breathing out kindness. Breathing in love to all parts of yourself, whether they act loving or not. And breathing out kindness to all sentient beings, whether acting kindly or not. For our loving kindness is not viewed through the lens of reward and punishment. We are not here to reward others with loving kindness for good behavior and punish those who act out by withholding it. We are here to breathe in love to all parts of ourselves and to breathe out kindness to all sentient beings. Breathing in love to all parts of yourself. Breathing out kindness for all sentient beings. For when not viewed through the lens of reward and punishment, loving kindness is the fuel that every heart requires for deeper healing, expansion, awakening, and total transformation. And all too often, whenever we or anyone else acts out from survival mode instead of from our highest integrity, it is a heart begging for the loving kindness that it doesn't know it requires to complete critical stages of its healing journey. So while you don't have to be best friends with people who mistreat, who manipulate, who coerce. In the safety of your own sanctuary space, safe within the boundaries of what works for you and what you can handle, we breathe in love to all parts of ourselves, and we breathe out kindness to all sentient beings. May the love of all be received with this in-breath. May kindness for all be extended outward through the out-breath. May the love of all be drawn in through this in-breath. And may kindness for all be extended outward through the out-breath. And to deepen this loving kindness meditation, we allow ourselves to remember that loving kindness is one of the highest attributes of your divine nature. Divinity is always meeting you with loving kindness and existing as the loving kindness within you. So when you take time to greet yourself with loving kindness, it is always a moment that you are remembering that you are the divine I am within the character, and not the character searching for the divine or for new ways to reinvent its imaginary I am. And so we start by greeting the mind. Greeting the mind as an expression of divinity. And that through the law of intention, however you greet your mind sets the intention for how your mind will operate within you. So if you want to experience the beauty of mind, we say, hello, beautiful mind. Because saying hello, beautiful mind is telling the mind, I know you are an expression of the divine I am, and I'm ready to experience this mind functioning in its highest divine beauty. And we send that very simple message to the mind that we're no longer going to support patterns of neurosis, and we are going to interrupt that activity and request that the mind return to its true nature of divine beauty, setting the intention for your mind to express the beauty of divinity in all the ways the mind functions by saying, hello, my beautiful mind. Hello, my beautiful mind. Hello, my beautiful mind. And if it helps you to touch your head while you say it so you can direct the energy, hello, my beautiful mind. And of course, a lot of people are first trying to change their minds before they praise their minds. And they work on their minds, and there's no end to the things you can work on in your mind, hoping for the day in which your mind functions in a better, more precise way to give it that compliment. But in the quantum field, we reverse that order, and we remember by praising the mind is what gives the mind permission to function in its highest expression of consciousness. So if we want to experience a beautiful mind, we let the mind know how beautiful it is. And we say, hello, my beautiful mind. And try these words with me. Hello, my beautiful mind. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my beautiful mind. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, my beautiful mind. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, my beautiful mind. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. And feel what happens when we praise the mind first, because as co-creators, the praise you offer your mind is the intention you set that commands the mind how to function over a period of time. So if you practice consistently greeting your mind with a positive affirmation, your mind will receive that command of intention and begin operating from that new higher vibrational frequency. Or if we neglect the mind, overlook the mind, ignore the mind, challenge the mind, or insult the mind, it will then stay in the default of acting out the unprocessed pain of your conditioning or the fears of your outdated belief systems. So if we want the mind and any part of ourselves to function from its highest consciousness as an expression of the divine I am, we set the frequency of intentionality through the affirmations we use to praise the mind. And the same is true for your heart. Let us greet this precious heart of yours, your precious heart that equally beats in the bodies of all, including my body. And we say, hello, my precious heart. Hello, my precious heart. Knowing everything we're doing in this loving kindness meditation, we're saying to your heart and all hearts at the same time, hello, my precious heart. For when we address the heart as being precious, it becomes an instrument of your highest consciousness instead of as a reflection of past pain and heartache. Hello, my precious heart. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my precious heart. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Notice how the mind and the heart and all parts of yourself are serving you, offering you wisdom and teachings without words that only become insights when you notice them. Teachings such as, if you spend time complimenting me, I function from a higher frequency of consciousness. So when our mind is beautiful and our heart is precious, we're allowing these to be instruments of divinity instead of containers of unresolved pain. And instead of trying to heal these parts of yourself to then offer your compliments later, instead we learn to offer the compliments first as a way of co-creating with reality the moving into timelines where your mind and heart are already functioning differently and in a far more precise, aligned, and flawless fashion. So instead of trying to change what you think is here, let's just move awareness into the timeline where the mind is already beautiful and the heart is already precious. And the moving out of the old timelines and into the new is what we experience as the transmutation process. And so we say to the heart, hello, my precious heart. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, my precious heart. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my precious heart. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Feel the difference. Feel the difference when loving kindness leads your spiritual journey instead of tucked somewhere in the background. Feel what happens when you praise different parts of yourself and how that praise as higher frequencies of your own divinity help wake up the divine I am in these parts such as mind and heart. And then we go to the body. The body, which is your vessel of awakening, your container of spirit, the living evidence that the divine I am is here, has been reborn, is resurrected. We are the second coming. And this body is its evidence. And so we say to the body, where the heart pumps blood to all your organs, the breath comes in and out. It sustains and holds together your inner sanctuary without you even thinking about it, so your body's a miracle. And whether we're healing diagnosis in the body, healing ideas of body image, dysmorphia, or in history of being shamed, whether we like the way our bodies look, or would rather it look or feel differently, we say to the body, hello, my miraculous body. Hello, my miraculous body. For if we call the body miraculous, it starts to function in greater alignment with the miracles you wish to experience and be more aware of. Hello, my miraculous body. Hello, my miraculous body. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, my miraculous body. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my miraculous body. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, miraculous body. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Now we bring loving kindness to the ego, our innocent ego, an ego always rooted in innocence, even though it may not always act innocently. An ego that doesn't know the strength of its innocence because it's too busy trying to have its needs met by living out a past it doesn't know is already done and gone. And so we say to the innocent ego, as a way of bringing more innocence into your ego, instead of cultivating a more spiritually educated ego, hello, my innocent ego. Hello, my innocent ego. And let your ego be seen and valued and heard by its beloved divine I am, that is you, its parent, its guardian, its protector, its higher self. You are the ego's higher self. Lost in a dream of thinking you're the ego, separate from your higher self. And so as the higher self, You say, "Hello, my innocent ego. Hello, my innocent ego. Hello, my innocent ego. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my innocent ego. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my innocent ego. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. One more for the ego. Thank you, my innocent ego. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. And next, we greet the world, our world. But we greet the world as the higher self of the world, which is called the consciousness of the world. And because through the intentionality of words, we wish to experience timelines where the world is continually expanding and awakening, how will we greet the world? Hello, my awakening, expanding world. Hello, my awakening, expanding world. Hello, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Thank you, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. And as we engage this loving kindness meditation of greeting all parts of ourselves using the affirmations as a way of accessing the higher frequencies of how we wish for these parts to function, moving ourselves into timelines where the mind is beautiful, the heart is precious, the ego is innocent, and the world is awakening, expanding. When we say, thank you for serving me, it is you who I serve, it means any which way the mind, heart, body, I forgot to put the body in there, our miraculous body, ego, world is operating, is not a mistake, it's not wrong, it's all happening by divine appointment. The mind, the heart, the body, the ego, the world is all serving you. And as you start to remember and perceive how these parts are serving you, you are serving it by learning how to build a relationship where each part is respected more as expressions of the divine I am. For when you relate to each part of self, or even the world, as divinity, through the law of intention, you are calling out of that form higher frequencies of experience. And so by learning to relate to yourself with more loving kindness, you create an expanded vibrational reality where the people that enter your life have to subconsciously meet you at the highest frequency that's closest to the vibration of how you're relating to yourself. And will only be able to spend time around you for as long as they can hold that frequency, which means the gift that we're giving to the world as we relate to ourselves with more loving kindness is not only a chance for the world to know our divine I am in all of its uniqueness and beauty and miraculous expansion, but we're equally giving the world a chance to get to know its divinity in our presence. So we give the world an opportunity to get used to knowing its own divine nature by being more rooted in our divinity. And we take time to be more rooted in our divinity by using the power of affirmation to greet and relate to all parts of ourselves as the divine I am, and nothing less than that. Because anything less than the divine I am is simply a misuse of imagination. And so we say, hello, beautiful mind. Hello, precious heart. Hello, miraculous body. Hello, innocent ego. Hello, awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. Hello, beautiful mind. Hello, precious heart. Hello, miraculous body. Hello, innocent ego. Hello, awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. One more. Hello, beautiful mind. Hello, precious heart. Hello, miraculous body. Hello, innocent ego. Hello, awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. And of course, the mind, the heart, the body, ego, and world. Five aspects for the fifth dimension. Feel what it's like right now, and maybe in the comments, right? How does it feel to use the power of affirmation through the law of intentionality, the law of intention, to move yourself into timelines where your mind is already beautiful, your heart already precious, your body already more miraculous, your ego already innocent, and your world already awakening and expanding? How does the way in which I'm transmitting this loving kindness and how it can help lead your healing journey from this moment forward in a more heart-centered manner, how is that touching you? Beautiful, expansive, woohoo, thank you. Feels like communion. I'm so blessed for this response. I keep smiling. Feels amazing. Graceful and kind. Feels very good. It feels harmonizing, whole and complete. I love that. Here's something I'll tell you as someone who transmits from the universe and has helped to facilitate healing for so many of you for the last 18 years. You can speak to your body with loving kindness, and you can loving kindness your way back into heaven. and you can return to the full realization of your divine I am. You can transform your body miraculously, and you can embody the highest vibrations of consciousness through loving kindness more than running around and trying to accomplish things on a spiritual to-do list or trying to master endless processes. And part of the reason why there are endless processes is to give that part, that seeking part, that hunger, a chance to wear out some of its energy. Like a parent who lets a hyperactive child run around a little bit to wear out the energy of the sugar they've ingested. And once we've worn out some of that energy, we slow down and we step into the next stages of our journey where things are more meaningful and kind and loving for the benefit of you and the ascension of all. Clarissa said, I feel respected. Feel how respected you feel. Feel what it's like to use spirituality to respect yourself, not using spirituality to disrespect yourself. And here's what's so amazing about this process. Whether you use this video on a regular basis to walk yourself through it. And the intention is that it will change the way you speak to yourself. Because truth be told, a lot of us experience treating ourselves in a hypercritical way. And the hypercritical voices in our head is just the echo of how other people have mistreated us or empathing the patterns that other people are still healing. And the reason why the world has historically been healing at a slower pace is because the world has been trained to believe that you have to accomplish something big before you can give yourself a big affirmation or compliment. The world's been run by reward and punishment. And so the world has been trained to punish itself until there's a reason for a reward. But we live in a spiritual dimension, a reality of all reward and no punishment. And so we learn to talk to ourselves with loving kindness now. And the loving kindness that you speak to yourself today, through the dimension of time and through the law of karma, the loving kindness you speak to yourself today becomes the softer nervous system you experience right now, and the higher functioning consciousness of your mind, body, heart, ego, and world will manifest a day or even a week later. So we talk loving kindness to ourselves today to prepare for a more expanded future, whether in a few minutes, a day, a week, or otherwise. Just as if we have a food that we're allergic to, what tastes good right now may give us an allergic reaction when we digest it soon thereafter. But using the positive aspect of the law of karma, the loving kindness that I speak to myself and the empowering choices I make today, help me start my tomorrow in a more aligned and connected way. So instead of looking for things to rush out of town, instead of looking at things to get out of your system, instead of looking for more things to resolve in yourself, what if you just met yourself exactly as you are and say, this is the first version that's going to receive my loving kindness. And by loving and offering kindness to this version of me, I see it as a teacher helping to bring more loving kindness out of me. And if I can face this one with loving kindness, it means I'm better prepared to meet other people in my life in just that aligned, connected, and heart-centered way. And so the depths and benefits of a more heart-centered path are actually radical. And in the old spiritual paradigm, what people perceived as a high-level teaching were teachings about things like enlightenment. That's because historically, in older timelines, the highest available realization was the awakening of the mind. But we've all incarnated into the earth right now to experience the awakening of the heart. And so in this new paradigm, high-level teachings isn't just a mental extrapolation of enlightenment. Enlightenment in the new paradigm is you will remember the divine I am that you are. You will remember the enlightenment that you are as you learn to treat yourself with the loving kindness that only the highest enlightenment knows. So old paradigm is about fathoming enlightenment. New paradigm is being enlightenment. And being enlightenment is loving kindness. Spirituality, when it's enlightenment in the absence of loving kindness, is a cult. Spirituality celebrating enlightenment through loving kindness is direct path. Let it be known. There is not going to be such high wisdom that it precludes or discounts loving kindness. There is no high level realization that looks down on loving kindness and goes, oh, that's little kid stuff. That's amateur hour. There is no such thing as self-realization in the absence of loving kindness. And so if someone is ever professing self-realization and is not being loving or kind, there's the tip-off. It might be a stage of transition, and there are many spiritual egos and versions people have to work through, including an ego that dresses up as self-realization. But the words and actions must always be aligned in love and kindness. You can see the flowers, but you have to smell the fragrance. And the loving kindness is always the fragrance of true self-realization. The highest enlightenment is always loving and kind. And so in honor of the highest enlightenment that you are bringing back into awareness, in honor of the world, we are helping to move through timelines of ascension. And in honor of moving you into timelines where your mind is already functioning beautifully, where your heart is already operating preciously, where your body is already working miraculously, where your ego is already expressing innocently, and your world is already expanded and awakened. Please join me in saying, hello, my beautiful mind. Hello, my precious heart. Hello, my miraculous body. Hello, my innocent ego. Hello, my awakening, expanding world. Thank you for serving me. It is you who I serve. And just as we end the transmission, if you have a question, I can maybe take a few questions. What a beautiful time this has been together. So I'm just going to look over at the comments. If you want to write in a question. Sometimes I have a way of doing that before they're even asked. Let's see. And if we can all take a moment, whether questions come in or not. Question, why are you so awesome? Oh, thank you so much. It's an honor to serve you. Can we just take a moment? And I love doing this. I do a transmission and it puts us in a space where questions don't exist. Isn't that funny? That's what everyone's saying. What questions? I love this. But let's just take a moment of processing. And can we just fathom for one moment that we have done a loving kindness meditation. And as you are feeling different in your body is a map of the world. So you're becoming aware of all the different parts of the world where the vibration of this light has been sent. The goodness you feel in this transmission you're receiving is being felt in your body, but your body is a map of the world, confirming where the light you're receiving and the light that you embody is being sent for the benefit of all. So can we take a moment and feel good that the work we are doing is not just uplifting our experiences, but over a period of time, helping to transform the experiences of all? Yes, we are here to heal ourselves. Yes, we're here to support others. We're not here to support others to the degree that we ignore ourselves, and we're not here to be so focused on ourselves we miss the world. It's a balance of equality. It's a balance of polarity. So can we take a moment and feel how good you feel in your body on one level has shown you how this transmission, this vibrational frequency, this new approach is bringing incredible benefit into your life. That's absolutely true. It is also showing you your body as a map of the world, all the different areas and places where this light has been sent to bring peace to all cities, to all continents, to all countries, to all families, to all men, to all women, to all children, to all animals, to all kingdoms, to all beings, throughout our ancestry, to all elders, and to all souls that have yet to incarnate, and to all souls who will incarnate, and to all souls that have incarnated. May this loving kindness that you are receiving be remembered as the light that is right now healing all as one. And that's why you're feeling so good, because you're experiencing the power of your divinity and how powerfully it transforms all by the power of love and kindness. Thank you so much for being a part of this beautiful experience together. Thank you for your participation, not only in your healing journey, but in the ascension of our earth. Thank you for shining your light and being the most brilliant, unique, and beautiful reminder of divinity walking this earth. I am Matt Kahn, serving you with love, greeting you with kindness, bowing in your presence, and honoring the light you shine. Now and forever. May all souls be free. May all hearts be healed. May our ascending world be acknowledged. May heaven on earth be remembered. All by the light you shine and the loving kindness you share. I love you all. Namaste.